Okay, so we've looked at several properties of Bessel functions starting from the series definition. So in this lecture we will work out the differential equation from which Bessel functions really come out, right? So the differential equation is often the starting point, but in the treatment that we have used, we are going to start from the, we have already given the series definition, and we will directly from the recurrence relation properties, we will show in this lecture how to work out the differential equation. Okay, so the idea is that we write down these two recurrence relations. You know, they are the recurrence relations which relate Bessel function of a certain order to the derivative of the Bessel function of, you know, the next order or the previous order, right? So j nu minus 1 of x is related to the derivative of j nu of x, and then there is also this extra term nu by x times j nu of x, and j nu plus 1 of x is equal to minus the derivative of j nu of x, and there is also this correction plus nu by x j nu of x, right? So we will use these two recurrence relations and work out the differential equation for which the Bessel function j nu of x of order nu is a solution, right? So let us take a derivative of the first of these two recurrence relations. So we have d by dx of j nu minus 1 of x is equal to the second order derivative d squared by dx squared of j nu of x. Then when you take a derivative of this stuff, so you get a plus nu over x times the derivative of j nu of x minus nu by x squared times j nu of x, right? So that's what is here. So let's work out the same, the left hand side, d by dx of j nu minus 1 of x, in a different way, and then we will simply equate the right hand sides, which will give us the differential equation that we are after. So in order to do this, we will shift nu to nu minus 1 in this recurrence relation. So we have j nu plus 1 of x on the left hand side, but we want to use this relation, but shift nu to nu minus 1, so that the left hand side will now become j nu of x is equal to minus d by dx of j nu minus 1 of x plus nu minus 1 divided by x times j nu minus 1 of x. Right, so if we rearrange this, we immediately have an expression for the derivative. D by dx of j nu minus 1 of x is actually nothing but this. So this j nu can come to the right hand side. So we have minus j nu of x plus nu minus 1 divided by x times j nu minus 1 of x. So now we have, but from the first recurrence relation, so it's, we are still not completely done. I mean, we are after this left hand side, but we can rewrite the right hand side, you know, entirely in terms of j nu's, right? So we don't want to work with j nu minus 1 of x like here. So we will rewrite j nu minus 1 of x using this recurrence relation in terms of this stuff, which is all in terms of j nu of x. So this relation can be rewritten as d by dx of j nu minus 1 of x is equal to minus j nu of x remains as it is, but in place of, in the second term, we write this factor nu minus 1 over x as it is, but in place of j nu minus 1 of x, we write the entire stuff, which comes really from this recursion relation. So we have d by dx j nu of x plus nu by x j nu of x. So now we are done. So we have actually equation 1 and equation 2 are both representations for the derivative of j nu minus 1 of x. All of this stuff is written in terms of j nu of x. So there may be a derivative or a second order derivative, but there is nothing in terms of j nu plus 1 of x or in terms of j nu minus 1 of x. So we have managed to, you know, find two different expressions for the same quantity, and so we equate the right hand sides of both of these equations, and we have this expression. So d squared by dx squared j nu of x will remain as it is, plus nu by x d by dx of j nu of x minus nu by x squared j nu of x must be equal to minus j nu of x. This also remains as it is, but we will have some cancellations from these terms. Nu minus 1 by x times d by dx of j nu of x plus nu by x j nu of x. So we see that this nu by x d by dx j nu of x will cancel with this nu by x, but there is this minus 1 by x will remain, and then minus nu by x squared will also cancel with this stuff, minus 1 times nu by x squared. So we'll be left with this minus j nu of x will come to the right hand side, so that will give us a plus j nu of x, and then we'll also be left with this nu squared by x squared j nu of x. So in fact, this, you know, careful rearrangement of terms so that all the stuff appears on the left hand side can be carried out, and then I will rewrite this resulting differential equation as a second order differential equation. It is a second order differential equation, but I will write it in terms of y and x just to highlight that this is really a differential equation in its own right, and this could have been the starting point of this discussion, as it is the case in many other treatments. So what I have done here is, I mean, I have multiplied throughout with x squared. So this is x squared d squared by dx squared. In place of j nu of x, I write y. Then I have plus x dy by dx. So this nu has gone, and only this minus 1 by x is the only thing that remains, and that gives me x dy by dx. You can check this, and then, you know, the stuff involving nu squared by x squared and this 1 together, they will amount to just x squared minus nu squared times y is equal to 0. So this is like the defining, you know, differential equation of which the solution is the Bessel function of order nu. Right, so if we look at this as the starting point, and so and look for a series solution via the Frobenius method, right? So we can get back the series expansion, and then we will see that that series expansion coincides with the series expansion definition that we started with, and you know, other properties can be worked out. Now it's a second order differential equation, so it must have an independent alternate solution as well. And so in this case, if for, you know, generic nu not equal to an integer, the independent solution turns out to be straightforward. It's already there. I mean, we see that this is, there is a nu squared alone which appears here. So if j nu of x is a solution, then so is j minus nu of x, right? Because it's, you know, in place of nu, if you put minus nu, you get back the same differential equation. So it, therefore, let's go to the series expansion and put minus nu in place of nu. So we have j minus nu of x is equal to summation over r going from 0 to infinity minus 1 to the r divided by r factorial. So I have a minus nu plus r the whole factorial in the denominator, x by 2 the whole power minus nu plus 2r. Now if nu is not an integer in general, I mean, we can immediately see from this relation that in this relation and the corresponding relation for j nu of x, that j nu of x is a series which starts with the power x to the nu, whereas j minus nu of x is a series which starts with x to the minus nu. So we can immediately argue that basically j nu of x and j minus nu of x are not only two solutions of this differential equation, but in fact they're independent solutions. So therefore, any arbitrary linear combination of j nu of x and j minus nu of x is also a solution of this differential equation. So that's basically the full general solution of this differential equation. But on the other hand, if nu is equal to n, if it's an integer, then it turns out that j minus n of x is actually not an independent solution, as we will see now. Right, so if you have j minus n of x, where, you know, n is an integer, then we have this expansion as it is. I have just plugged in the, it's basically the same expression, except that in place of nu I have n. Now it turns out that the first few terms here will actually vanish. So the reason is that we have minus n plus r the whole factorial in the denominator, and the factorial of a negative integer is actually infinite. So you have 1 over or some stuff over infinity, so basically all those terms don't contribute. And so in fact here the series expansion actually starts from n. So the first, you know, terms starting from 0 all the way up to n minus 1, the first n terms, you know, if you just take this stuff and put n in place of nu, we can immediately argue that this is the same as r going from n to infinity. The reason is that, you know, when r is equal to 0, r equal to 1, r equal to 2, all the way up to r equal to n minus 1, this factorial is going to give us actually infinity. Right, so factorial function as we have seen, is generalized using the gamma function, and then you can check that the gamma function, you know, the definition for factorial using the gamma function will actually give you infinity for the factorial of a negative number. So all these terms, the first n terms are gone, and so then you start from r equal to n to infinity, and now we rewrite this in terms of, you do a change of variable. So r minus n can be defined as p, and then this index p will run from 0 to infinity. So p goes from 0 to infinity minus 1 to the, in place of r we have to write n plus p, and this r will becomes p plus n, and this minus n plus r is of course p. So in place of minus, so this should actually be not minus nu, but it should be minus n. So let's correct this. So minus n plus 2r, and then we have x by 2 to the whole power n plus 2p, right? So r is replaced by n plus p. So plus 2n will give you n, then there's also 2p. Now this is the same as, I can pull out this minus 1 to the n outside, and so then I'm left with, so I might as well use, you know, it's a dummy index, I'm just rewriting it in terms of r, because it gives back for us the familiar expansion we have for Jn of x, where we used r. It doesn't matter, you can use p or r, it doesn't matter. So immediately we see that in fact j minus of n of x is actually nothing but minus 1 to the n times Jn of x. So Jn of x and j minus n of x really carry the same information when n is integer. So therefore, the differential equation when nu is an integer, you know, the Bessel function gives only one independent solution. The other independent solution turns out to have a logarithm. So this Frobenius series does not quite work out, and there is another solution, but we will not go into that. So these kinds of applications, you know, these kinds of solutions of the Bessel function differential equation only appear in some very, very special contexts, and you know, you don't want to work in intervals that include the origin, because you have this, you have one of this solution blowing up in a logarithmic fashion. So we will, we are just pointing out in passing that indeed there is another solution even for when u is an integer, but we will not go into the details of that solution. Okay, that's all for this lecture. Thank you.